Welcome back to another Flipping Tables. Today we have another Kickstarter prototype game for you. No box to show you because it is definitely a Kickstarter with no box quite yet. We were sent the prototype components. It is a card game called Rolling Plunder, where you are the captain of a pirate ship and you are trying to be the first one to upgrade your ship to the latest and greatest, most powerful ship. And then win the game. So this is the layout of the game. There are several different cards to choose from. We have plunder cards, which you can purchase after you defeat other ships on the high seas and gain doubloons, which you're going to gain throughout the game. There's the ship deck, and these are the ships you're going to go up against. You're going to try to catch them and then go up against battle with them. And then there's crew that you can
recruit
into your ship. And so you can see there's the recruit row there. Everybody starts with a schooner, and that schooner, basically, you can see here on the sails, there's cannons and there's the max crew level. The sails tells you how many times you can roll your dice to catch a ship. The cannon is how many times you can roll the dice to attack the ship. And then your max crew number is how many maximum crew members you can have on your ship, which is shown down here. There's only so much space on a ship. So you're trying to upgrade your ship, like starting from the schooner. You need 4 victory points to upgrade it to a brigantine. And then you need 6 victory points to upgrade to a galleon. And then once you get 8 victory points, you are
the victorious.
I don't even know what I'm speaking
You're
anymore.
Victorious or the victor?
Words are hard. So this is the way the game starts. So each turn, you're going to flip over a ship. In this case, it's a racing sloop. I can decide to try to chase it. Now, this racing sloop has no cannon, so it's not going to fight back.
So if you catch it, you win.
You win, but I need to catch it. It means this ship can roll its dice 3 times, and I can only roll twice. So I'm going to try to catch it. Tico is now going to, one of the other players will take on the role of that ship. I'm going to try to chase it. I'm going to roll my dice. So I have an X, which means I cannot re-roll that dice. I have a sail. So that's good. That's what I want. Now I can roll one more time. So that's twice. So I only have one sail. Tico is now going to roll for the other ship.
So I got one sail, one X.
Yeah.
And I'm going to re-roll this cannon. And I got a second sail.
He got a second sail. Now that means the ship got away and it's basically out of the game there. Yeah. I did not capture that ship.
Now, per turn, you get 2 opportunities. So you have an opportunity to chase after a second ship.
I'm going to chase. At this point, there's no point not to chase after a second ship. Oh, gosh. So here's the problem. So now this ship is a Royal Navy ship. It's powerful. It's fast. But it's worth a good amount of victory points. These are the points you need to upgrade your ship. This ship, however, I don't have to chase after it. It attacks me immediately. And
so your options are to fight back or to run.
So let's say I want to fight back. I'm going to fight back. I can only roll once. Okay. I only have one cannon where he has 2, so he can roll twice. So I'm going to roll once and hope I get 3 cannons, which I probably won't.
No.
In fact, I got no cannons, so I will probably lose.
Well, you're guaranteed to lose.
With
the Royal Navy, a tie goes to the Royal Navy. So if I also roll 0, that's a tie.
That's a tie. So I've already lost. It doesn't matter. You don't even have to roll. I've already lost.
It's fun for me.
Of course it's fun.
Look at this. There's that cannon that's going to take you out.
All right. So because I lost, again, the ship gets away and I lose my sailor. He goes into the discard pile and... basically, that's the end of my turn.
Yeah.
If I still had this sailor at the end of my turn, I would actually gain 2 coins for him, plus 1 coin for me as the captain.
Sure.
And I now have 3 doubloons ready to spend on my next turn. Basically, the gameplay goes that you show a ship. If this card comes up, that's a mutiny.
Yep, the black spot.
Black spot is a mutiny. If you get 2 mutinies, then you discard... bunch of cards from your hand of play. Game or your round ends immediately as soon as you get a black spot. And so there's other cards like a hidden map allows you to roll and gain extra doubloons plus a plunder card. Plunder cards are in your hand. They give you additional abilities that you can play at any time. Play before any chase to automatically win the chase. Play at the end of your hunt phase to draw one additional ship card. Normally you're hunting, you can only hunt for up to two ships. So the plunder cards are what gives you different abilities, whether modify. It's for yourself or for your opponent. So I could play this enemy of my enemy, play anytime, give any non-player ship plus two attack or minus one attack. I could play this against an enemy or on an enemy so that Tico
makes
it may
more difficult
lose
for your opponents.
Right. So really, I mean, that's really what the game entails. There is a lot of luck involved
in
this game.
The dice roll, you're rolling three die, and it really comes down to, again, a bad roll like that. You don't re-roll those X's.
Yes.
So you could very, very quickly be in trouble in one of those things.
So you want to win against ships, because you're going to, once if you win against that ship, you put it in your collection, you now have victory points to spend towards upgrading your ship. And it also gives you the ability to recruit more members or more shipmates from this line here up to the level. So with the schooner, I can recruit level one. I could bring Fido in, right? If I had captured this ship, I can now add Fido to my list, which gives me plus one sail to rolls. But I can only have a max of two according to my ship. As I upgrade that ship, I can now have three. And if I upgrade to a galleon, I can now have four, and I can have up to level three. So you can see each of these shipmates have levels on them. So on a galleon, I can have any of them on my ship, and I can have up to four of them on my table. And they give me money at the end of my turn. They give me abilities, you know. And really, ultimately, you're fighting against ships. There are cards that allow you to fight against your other players.
Yeah.
But ultimately, you're trying to gain victory points to upgrade your ship. Eight ships, once you have a galleon, eight victory points leads you to a victory.
Yeah. It's a fun game. It's very thematic with the pirate.
It's very thematic.
A lot of take that
yes.
mechanics, which is very thematic to the pirate, which I kind of like that. You know, some fun ones with the drunkard during a chase. You can discard him to automatically
yes, right.
Gain an extra sail roll.
So or to you actually win the sail roll
right.
if you get rid of that.
Because you're taking him and
you're throwing him overboard.
So you're lightening your load. So it makes sense. So some fun things like that to be able to use your
yeah.
crewmates and to sort of rotate through some of them, gain more gold as you go through. It's a fun thematic game.
Now keep in mind what we're playing with. These are prototype components. So what you're seeing could change by the time it hits Kickstarter.
Yeah.
The quality could change. And even some of the rules could change since we have received it. Personally, I mean, I enjoyed the game. I do find, however, it's very luck-based. It's all based on dice roll. That is it. There's no huge strategy involved.
Yeah.
The only real strategy is whether or not you're going to push your luck or recruit players. Because if you push your luck to try to take another ship and lose, you can't recruit someone new that turn. And that's the push your luck angle
yeah.
of it. I would like to see more plunder cards that give you advantages during rolls.
Yeah.
To me, I found I had a bunch of plunder cards in my hand
that you weren't going to use.
I was never going to use because they just didn't feel useful to me. I would rather see things that I can maybe add to my ship, you know, extra cannons,
right.
extra sails, you know, to improve the ship itself or to give me an advantage in a fight. That's what I'd like to see more of.
Yeah.
A little bit more strategy of when do I want to use this card to, you know, like a plus one to cannons or something like that.
Yeah, none of my cards felt like these are going to turn the tide.
Right.
I just felt like I have stuff, it's there, I may use it, but nothing, I don't know, nothing that really
nothing
stood
huge,
out.
Substantial. Yeah.
yeah.
So this is Rolling Plunder by War Games, and it is coming to Kickstarter soon. And I'm hoping we will also speak to the creator about it on Kicking Tables. So look for that coming soon as well. Thanks for joining us for Flipping Tables.
R. R?
R.
It's a hard R.
That's what pirates say.
Do they?
They say, "Arr, subscribe
to us."
Does this
not look like a sad Freddie Mercury?
Sad Freddie Mercury. He's looking down there to the subscribe button, thinking, I should press it.
You should.